As a politician, my ethic is simply this. I have to make a difference. I have to be there and go to bat for people who have no voice or who people don't listen to or who are vulnerable. And so I've always done that. What I learned was that this was a diverse place even then. And that was a very welcoming way to feel. We all kind of bonded and made friends, and it didn't really matter where we came from. But also one of my professors, Moira O'Brien, was very chic and very feminine and very bold. And I remember thinking, I can be a woman, I can be feminine and still be a doctor.
Hailing from Trinidad and Tobago, Dr. Fry is Canada's longest serving female Member of Parliament. Dr. Fry has served as President of the Vancouver Medical Association, and she has campaigned and campaigns fiercely for women's, Indigenous peoples, and minority rights issues.
How does a girl from Trinidad and Tobago, whose parents, your dad was a tailor, your mum was a secretary, how did you end up in the 60s in Dublin studying medicine?
The Royal College was doing a pilot project in that very year in which they were taking 10 people in their pre-med class who had the top of the bell curve in humanities, arts, and or languages. And so I got in on that basis.
When I came here, there were quite a lot of people of colour at the College of Surgeons because lots of people came from all over the world to study here. So I didn't feel any different.
Take us back to what Dublin was like in the 60s. I mean, the food.
There was one Chinese restaurant, the Luna, if I recall, and there was one Indian restaurant. It didn't matter because we couldn't afford to go to any of them anyway. We were scraping along as students.
You were saying to me earlier you weren't allowed to wear trousers at the time.
Couldn't wear trousers, but my goodness, we wore short skirts.
What happened over the course of time that you were working away as a doctor that morphed you to where we are now?
Well, I supported a particular person when he was running for leadership. His name happened to be Jean Chrétien, and he said to me, I want you to run. And at the time, I had a very downtown practice in Vancouver, and I had a large number of LGBT patients. And I also saw how they were denied access to healthcare in a country that had universal access. So I said to him, I'd run on one condition. You will amend the Canadian Human Rights Act to add sexual orientation as a prohibited ground for discrimination. And he said, I can do that. And I said, okay. And I said, give it to me in writing.
I don't know if Hedy in the 60s could ever have imagined where her life was going to take her. But if you could give your younger self some advice about going forward in life, what would it be?
My dad used to always tell me, you know, as you walk down the road and you look at the side and you see an interesting looking side alley, go down it. If you don't like what's there, you can always come back and go along your path. But take that chance, take a risk.
Do you have a proudest moment?
When we passed the Canadian Human Rights Act and eventually same-sex marriage. Because it was suddenly people who were unequal under the law became equal. And it was remarkable, it was wonderful. That's why I dance in these 8-inch heels and in Pride Parade in a costume, because it is a celebration of the right of people to stand up and say, look at me, I am who I am and I'm proud to be who I am.
Well, I found it very refreshing as someone who's still in medical school to see a physician whose career path had so many different twists and turns. Doing medicine, you're not locked into a corner.
Hedy was the light of the class, really, because she wasn't just beautiful, she was talented. I always knew that she was a leader.
Speak up, speak out. Always go to bat for people. We made a difference, a real difference to people's lives.